Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2497. How do we display gamma and beta symbols in Excel? All right, great question sent in. How to display gamma and beta? I had to go look it up. They're mathematical functions, right? So I knew that the Unicode is going to be the key to this. So Google Unicode gamma. We end up at this page that tells us that it's U plus O3B3. But what do we do with that? Two functions in Excel. One sounds like it'll solve your problem called Unicode, but that's not it. These functions are based on old functions in Excel called Code and Char, C-H-A-R. So if you would ask for equal code of A, it tells you that the ASCII code is 65. You have to use the other one, the C-H-A-R function then. Give me the C-H-A-R of 66 to get the B. Unicode and UNICHAR work the exact same way. So if you try and do an equal Unicode of this O3B3, it's not what you want at all, right? And then it's not so simple as equal UNICHAR of O3B3 in quotes. That gives you a value error because this number, O3B3, is hexadecimal. And Excel is expecting a decimal number there. Every website is going to show you the hexadecimal numbers. Very frustrating. So the horrible formula that you're going to use out here is first on the inside, you're going to use HEX2DEC. That converts a hexadecimal number to a decimal number. There we are. And then send that into the UNICHAR and you get the right answer. What is O3B3 in decimal? It's 947. So I guess if you wanted to memorize this, equal UNICHAR of 947. The beta symbol is O3B2, which is 946. So there again, you're either going to use equal UNICHAR, C-H-A-R of 946 to get the beta, or if you can't remember that, UNICHAR of the HEX2DEC of O3B2, close. Right, both pretty horrible, all right? But if you're creating gamma and beta all the time, maybe that's the way to go. All right, oh man, did you see it on ESPN? It was crazy, that 30-minute Excel competition generated so much news. Oz was on the radio twice in England, I think the Times radio and the BBC. I was on the radio twice in Australia, both first in Sydney and then a 15-minute segment out in Perth. It was great fun. And if for some reason you're someplace where you don't have ESPN and you can't get it, don't tell anyone, but click that I in the top right-hand corner and you might find a rogue version of the event if you want to watch it. About that. Also, hey, we're at 2497. That means that three episodes from now is 2500. What should I do? You know, I don't just want it to be some boring video about gamma and beta, for God's sakes. So if you have any ideas of what to do special for 2500, let me know. All right. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.